Welcome to the resident training for the new community experience feedback system here at Esplanade Lakewood Ranch. So, first obvious question is, why do we need a community experience feedback system? Well, we believe that living and working in Esplanade should be an outstanding life experience, not just for the residents, but also for our staff. By understanding what's going well and what's not, we're going to be able to improve experiences across the board. Today, we use email to track all the information related to what's happening in Esplanade, but we have no good data that tells us what we should continue to do and what we should change to do better. In addition, the current process can leave the resident out of the communication loop sometimes. We need a closed loop process so that the resident always knows what's happening and will know when an issue's been resolved. So the community experience feedback system is going to give us a lot of data. We can use this data to manage our budget more effectively, to help us manage our contractors better, to anticipate needs of the community effectively, and help us overall understand how to serve the residents and improve the living experience at Lakewood Ranch. What is a community experience feedback system? It's a web-based system where the residents and staff can enter and track various aspects of our experience here at Esplanade Lakewood Ranch. So for example, if you went to a fitness class and you really enjoyed it, you can provide feedback to the fitness team so they know, hey, that class went well, maybe we should be looking at scheduling more sessions. Or let's say you had dinner at the Culinary Center last night and the server went well above and beyond. You can tell the food and beverage manager about that experience so they can give that feedback to the server. Again, posting positive experiences tells our management what they should continue to do and reinforces what we consider good behavior. Conversely, let's say you have an issue with a sprinkler system at your house. You can put in a ticket on the feedback system and it'll instantly notify the landscape team. And as they go to resolve the issue and they put notes into the system, you'll get copied on those notes so you can see what's going on. Additionally, let's say you are in the pool area at the amenity center and there's a problem. Could be a dirty umbrella, could be a chair in the pool, who knows what. But you can go enter that in the system and the Lifestyles team will go take care of the issue and keep you in the loop as they track the progress and eventually resolve the problem. So the process is very straightforward. Once a resident submits a feedback ticket, the manager in charge of that area is notified instantly and can open the ticket. Then, as the manager is going through and resolving whatever issue is on the ticket, the resident will be notified via email, as well as if they log into the system, every time the manager enters a note about the ticket or assigns it to somebody to be resolved. And the great thing is that within the system, notes are kept as a running commentary so you can look back through the progress on a ticket at any given time. Lastly, the system is automatically going to escalate tickets and send reminders to the manager if a ticket hasn't been updated in 2 business days. So for example, if you enter a ticket on a Wednesday and then on Friday, they put a note in there, the system will ignore the weekend because it's not a business day. But then by Tuesday, if there's no other note put on the system, a reminder will go to the managers. This way, we won't have tickets falling through the cracks. All right, that's the background for the system. Let's go take a look at the system and see how it actually works. Welcome to the Esplanade at Lakewood Ranch Community Experience Feedback System. When you first get to the system, you'll be asked to log in. Your user ID will be your member number. And the very first time you log in, you'll want to click on the link down here that says forgot, reset your password. And that will send a password reminder to your email registered in the system, which is the same one that you get your Esplanade invoices to, and will provide you the link to reset your password so that you can log in for the first time. Also notice down here, there is a link that says switch to mobile format. The system itself does not have an app for the iPhone or Android. It wants you to use the browser on your phone to log into the system if you use it that way. The mobile version does not function the same way that the full desktop version does. So we encourage you, even on your phone, to make sure that if it does switch to mobile format automatically, you'll see a link down here that says switch to full version. Click on that, you get back to this screen. That'll provide you a much richer experience. You'll get to enjoy all the features and functionality that we're going to show you during this video. You should note that on an iPad or any other tablet, the full version works extremely well and is much easier to use. Please remember that the system is not to be used for emergencies. If you have an emergency around the community, please call the 24/7 emergency hotline number that's published on the esplanadelwr.com website. Once you've got your user ID and password set, we're going to click on the sign-in button to get into the system. The system immediately takes you to the screen where you can submit a new experience. You can select from a series of quick picks that we have set up for you that cover most areas of our community. You'll see that the list is set up alphabetically by the major areas within the community. If you know that the issue you want to put in has to do with a wellness center, you can start typing wellness, and you can see that it will quickly shorten the list to just those topics around the wellness center. The very first topic you'll see is suggestions. For every area, we do have an area where you can just enter general suggestions that aren't related to a specific complement or issue that you're having around the system. These suggestions, like all the others, will immediately go to the department manager so they can start a conversation with you around your suggestion. If you are entering something else, so let's say that you have gone to the wellness center and you have a comment on the fitness center. Once you enter it, you'll get the full screen where you can enter everything about your experience. You'll notice that by using the quick picks, the system will automatically fill in the location, in this case was the wellness center, and start filling in some of the experience areas for you. Most experience areas have a subtype 1 and a subtype 2. The subtype 2 allows you to get more specific about what your particular issue is. In this case, let's say that we have a machine that needed some maintenance. I'm going to come down here and I'm going to mention that the treadmill in the middle was squeaking. You'll notice that in the full description, all the comment boxes here, there is a spell checker. So if you right click on the word that's underlined in red, it'll help you solve your typing problems like it does for me. Once I've entered the experience here, you'll see in this case, it's telling me that this is going to be assigned to Rob Commissar. He's in charge of the Wellness Center and the issues that come in from the Wellness Center. Once I've entered my subtype 2 and what my particular issue was, all I have to do is hit submit. And I'm all done. What's going to happen is on the screen, I will see a confirmation. I'm also going to see that while the issue was submitted to Rob, Ryan is going to be his backup on this as his manager. Both Rob and Ryan will be notified that this issue was submitted into the system. Let's submit another experience. Let's say we're out in the golf course. What you'll see is that the screen for submitting a golf issue is slightly different. We have three new fields here. First one being tee time. So let's say I had an 8:45 tee time. But it wasn't around, it wasn't until noon, slightly slow round. It wasn't until noon that I actually noticed the issue I'm going to report. And the issue was on the 8th hole. And specifically, there was no sand in the sand bucket at the tee. All right, terrific. So question becomes, why enter tee time and the time you notice the issue? Very often, if somebody else has been there around the course before you, they've seen the issue and they've reported it, and it may already be corrected. So this gives the golf team the ability to look at it and say, oh, we knew about that, we corrected it, and they'll reply to you immediately that they have taken care of the issue. Now that we've submitted a couple issues, let's take a look at one of the emails that comes in after you submitted an issue. Here's the email confirmation I received after submitting the golf course experience. And you'll be able to see everything that you entered on the ticket. There is a link right here that will take you directly back to the system. You'll have to log in if you're not already logged in, but it'll take you to the system to this experience. If you're not logged in, all you have to do to add a note to this experience is hit reply and type in whatever you'd like them to know. Actually, there was one scoop left. It wasn't truly empty. And you hit send. And that note will go back to that experience ticket. As a note, usually takes a couple of minutes to come through. So why don't we back out of the ticket? You'll be able to interact with the system by using your email versus having to log in every time. And the only time that you cannot use your email is when you want to create the initial ticket in the system. Let's submit one more experience. Let's say I have a landscaping issue. And in particular, it is with irrigation. First, what you'll notice about landscaping, and we'll in the future be able to do this in other forms, is we've provided some of the basic maintenance policies here just so as you go to submit an issue, you have an idea of what is going to be considered an issue, what may be considered a homeowner's responsibility. As I scroll down, you'll see, interestingly enough, the location is set up to my home address. So for every user in the system, we've already put your location is in as the address so that when the ticket is submitted to the landscape team, they know immediately where the issue is. So I chose landscaping irrigation as my issue, and let's say that I have a broken timer. So my timer has not worked for the past week. All right, that's it. And I'm going to submit the experience. What you'll notice in this one, which was a little different, was that you didn't see who it was assigned to until you hit submit. Based on certain criteria in the system, you may not see it on the screen as you're entering it, but you will always see it once you've entered the issue itself. At this point, either you can close the ticket because it's been resolved, or more often, the manager who resolved the ticket will close the ticket. Once the ticket's closed, you'll get a notification of that as well. So we've entered three issues. Question becomes, how do I see what's going on with my issues? Well, you notice up here, the very top link in your menu just simply says My Esplanade Experience Feedback. When you click there, it automatically takes you to a list of all of your tickets. As you can see, I entered one on October 3rd, that was yesterday. That was, again, in the irrigation experience. And because in substatus it says new, I can tell that the person it's assigned to has not yet opened up the ticket and done any work on it. Conversely, that golf course experience ticket that we just entered says in process. That's because some action was taken against the ticket. It could be that it was assigned to a different person, there was a note added, they changed the status of the ticket. Anything will move it from new to in process. The system has an automated rule that says if a ticket stays in the new status for more than one business day, a reminder automatically goes to the person it's assigned to as well as that person's manager. Once you're in the My Experiences screen, you can look at any ticket by clicking on the subject for that ticket. In the case of the golf course experience, we will be able to see who the ticket was assigned to, in this case, Steve Rodriguez, as well as any notes that have been entered by the ticket, either by you as the resident or by somebody on staff that's working on the ticket. And that is the full extent of the system. It's very straightforward. If you have any questions or comments or concerns about the system, on the sign-in page, we put a contact phone number where you can call, and if nobody answers the phone, you can leave a message and they will get back to you as quickly as possible regarding your issue with the system.